To pregnant journalist Viv Groskop. When it comes to celebrity mums to be, there are two very different types. First off, there's the glamorous ones who manage to look swell but not swollen. And then, thankfully, there's also the biggest beautiful brigade who make it easier for the likes of us to feel good about themselves as they approach motherhood. Now, clearly, she can't help but compare herself to other women who are also pregnant. But were we the same when that was the case for us?
What, comparing?
Yeah.
No, because when I was pregnant, I decided that I was the only pregnant woman in the world. Because I felt that special. I thought, no one can do this like me. This was in the early stages. In the latter stages, shall we say, certainly with Kira, I was brought it back in at 5 months because they said it must be twins. And it wasn't.
No.
Yeah, so yes. And people used to come up and go, not long now, and I'd go another 4 months.
Really? 5 months, Cole?
Yeah.
Do you think that's because it was your third baby?
No, because it was like that with the first and second as well. I just turned into, all I was missing was a trunk when I was pregnant. And I ate buns as well, which didn't help.
Only, I think, when I found out I was pregnant, I was ready for the big ankles, and I just thought I would look like somebody had put a foot pump up my... Mm. And, you know, that would be me. Mm. And I was really pleasantly surprised, actually. I worked really hard at staying in shape throughout pregnancy, and I didn't even start
That's
to show
where
till...
went wrong, then.
I don't think I started to show till 6 months. I was working with you, Arlene, wasn't
absolutely.
I?
Absolutely, and you'd forget you were pregnant, because you just carried on. Yeah. The fact that you happened to be pregnant was, like, out there. Oh, except the day you had the accident.
Oh, I had a car accident.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
I had a car accident. We were doing a show at Wembley, and I thought, I don't know, I can't feel the baby kicking very much, and I got a bit worried. So Arlene said, right, we're going to get a doctor in. And I had a DIY scan in a pair of sparkly shoes. You don't want to know. Where literally they were going, 4 minutes till you're on stage, Wembley Arena, right? And they put jelly on my belly and they gave me a scan and we heard a heartbeat and I burst into tears. I was so happy. High-fived Arlene, legged it onto stage and went, good evening, Wembley!
Absolutely, yeah.
All was good in the world.
It was weird. I've had two completely different pregnancies. My first daughter, I was in Hollywood, actually making a movie with the Village People. Can't Stop the Music. Choreographing on roller skates, dancing on skates, and I was me with this bump at the front. In fact, I'd forgotten I was pregnant until I was around 7 months and we were doing our warm-up and then we came to rib isolations and one of the boys, the Village People, David Hodo, who had the hard hat, said, I'm really sorry, but I just can't see what you're doing. And suddenly I realised, of course he couldn't see my ribs. There was this sort of bump moving along with my ribs. And that's the first time I'd really stopped to think about it. And I had the baby. I flew from New York to LA, where I'd been working in New York, flew to LA, had the baby, and up was up and back. Second one, you know, I didn't believe there's such a thing as morning sickness. Let me tell you, there really is.
Yeah.
And forgive me for ever even thinking that. I was sick, I was fat, I was tired.
And also, Arlene, you were a mum of... You were 47 at the time.
Yes.
That's an incredible age at which to have your second child.
Yeah. But it was tough, and you know now I know what pregnancy really means, and it has opened a kind spot into my heart to pregnant women.
Yeah, I think you'll never ever be unsympathetic to another pregnant woman. Sherry, you've had two kids. You've had an imaginary child and a real one.
Yeah. The imaginary one was quite easy, that birth.
Yeah, no problem.
The second one wasn't, but it took me a long time to have Keely, and so when I got pregnant, at 5 weeks, I actually bought a caftan. Walking around like this, and people going, what have you got on? And, of course, I didn't show till I was, like, 7 months. So, I mean, Anna, it was... But I have to say, though, Colleen, once I got to, like, 7½ months, it went... Whoomph, like that.
Filled the caftan.
Oh, absolutely. I filled the caftan, two caftans, and I put on 4 stone like that.
Oh, good.
But then, but then I had a thing, you see, about mashed potato and gravy, and that's all I ate. So when I'd had Keely, I then had nightmares of all this mashed potato running down the street trying to swallow me. So don't ever get a fixation when you're pregnant, girls. Don't ever get, you know, a craving, because it'll come and eat you.
Really good. Count on Sherry to take it somewhere really weird. Being chased by a mashed potato. OK, let's leave our bumps there.